Hey folks, Jason here from Westside Stores and Bucktail Adventures. So today we're going to do a quick little talk about downriggers and how I set them up and what I do here on the boat when we're out guiding. We're out on a kokanee fish right now on a little lake, Monty Lake, near Kamloops. And you can see here on the boat, we've got four downriggers set. So when I'm running four downriggers, I make sure that the back two downriggers are the deep two, and those lines are further out than the side two. The side two are shallower and a little closer to the boat when they're set. We're running 2106 downriggers here. They're the high speed, high performance downriggers. And again, for me guiding, it's up, down. You know, there's times where we really get into some action and there's lots going on. So I need them up, reset them, get them back down, get them into fish. I run braid on all mine. I've taken the stainless cable off. Cable was the original, it's still very popular, but for me, it gets rid of that annoying line hum in the water, and I can retie. If something happens and we do hang the bottom and end up breaking anything, we can retie real quick. I don't deal with the crimps and things like that. And I'll tell you right now, it's the story we joke with everyone. If you fish near the bottom, you are gonna find it. So even I do once in a while, you get hung up, you know, the bottom jumps out and you get it, so you can fix that pretty quick. So we've got rods set up. I like to set my rods pretty tight in the downrigger. Some people leave them a little loose. I really load them so if fish snaps them out, I can see it. I can see the fish bouncing when he's hitting. We're looking for this, you know. These kokanee are just gonna jiggle the rod a little bit and we gotta pop them out. Scotty builds a couple different sizes of clips. We're using the little lake size clips right now. They're a little smaller for these smaller fish, and I run them a lot on the Shuswap for our lake trout and rainbow there as well. And when we go on our ocean trips, we run the real big clips. They've got a line on there, and we use that line to judge how deep we're setting our fishing line inside the jaws of the clip. That's a good reference point. So on these ones, we've got them buried in pretty tight because we're down deep. Those clips also have an adjustable setting. You can set them for two different stiffnesses on the clip. So all the way back is pretty tight. Run that little tab forward, and it softens the clip up. When we're running the downriggers like this, and I've got four on the boat, I run the booms fully extended, so they're all 60 inches out. Big thing that helps us are the weight retrievers. So I've got them tied in here. We pull it in and it pulls that cannonball right into the boat for us. So any rough water, like today is not a big deal. You can pick the cannonballs that are the booms up and swing the cannonballs in. But for me, the weight retrievers are a big help. Pulls them in, rough water, I'm not worried about going overboard. So I hope this has helped, and get out and enjoy some fishing, and follow us at Westside Stores and Bucktail Adventures.